Wednesday, B-Fam. It's a good day to learn and crave for new learnings. Kasama pa rin dito sa inyong favorite global hangout. Now, sabi nila, our hunger for wisdom should never waver, even outside of the classroom. Now, learning should never stop at any point in life, and we should always be curious sa mga bagay na nakapag-spark ng interest sa atin. At yan ang goal natin for this episode. I'm Denise Arell, a forever student of life na makakasama nyo dito pa rin sa Place to Be. Be happy, be you, BRGY. And of course, isa pang super excited na makasama kayo sa isang bonding ay ang ating B-Cata from Mississauga, Canada, who's now in Africa. What's up, Carmela?
Happy Wednesday. It's midweek, but we still have so much exploration in store for you coming up. And of course, as Dee said, she's a forever student of life. And this is one of the best things that you can be because you're forever learning. And let's follow suit and let life and the people around us become our greatest teachers. Again, this is your B-Cata Carmela, normally from Mississauga, Canada, but today from Africa. So
oh
exciting.
My goodness. Babe, thank you for joining us, even if you're on vacation right now. So, how's Africa?
It is so hot.
I mean,
I'm burning.
You're burning. But what have you been doing? Like, what have you been exploring and learning out there?
I've been learning how to surf. So I'm trying to be a forever student out here. I'm learning how to surf. It's been the best. Like, let's go. Learning new things.
I'm so happy for you. And I am so thankful that you still cut out some time for us, you know, despite all the fun that you're having. Because, you know, in a time where we can easily access you, we can also easily access information with one click, play and share. And our educators and teachers today have an even bigger responsibility to fulfill their mission. So knowledge definitely is power. Real or maybe even fake man yan, may impact pa rin to sa ating society. So now, more than ever, mahalaga talaga tutukan ang pag-spread ng right information and knowledge, lalo na sa kabataan. So yeah, it's a very new thing, but super duper powerful.
This new year is the perfect opportunity to start this conversation. Kaya naman, let's not delay this any further and let's continue this inspirational and educational kwentahan here on Saucy.
Today, we will be having not just one, but two special guests who committed their lives to sharing their knowledge. It's their life's mission. Our first guest ay isang full-time English teacher sa high school and college, kilala sa pag-share ng mga English grammar and pronunciation lessons sa kanyang YouTube channel. Oh, I love that. Please welcome Charlene Joyco of Charlene TV.
What's up, Teach?
Hi. Teach talaga.
Hi,
hello,
Steve.
Po. Thank you for being here. You may have a seat and greet all of our B-Fams out there right now.
Hi, B-Fams! Welcome to our show. Welcome to my channel. I was
yes, welcome to my channel. Nasanay na.
Oh.
Okay lang, that happens. But yeah, how are you? I'm so glad you were able to be here with us.
It's a new year. I'm excited to continue my English 101 online class. And I miss my worldwide students, as well as my students in Department of Education, of course. How about you, Denise? How are you doing?
It's doing great. It's actually so great that today we don't have just one, but two guests, right, Carmel?
Alrighty. Okay, so our next guest is an inspiring global Pinoy from Saudi Arabia whose mission in life is to bridge the knowledge gap and to inspire her students in the best way possible. So let's welcome our teacher, Miss Rachel May Tolentino.
Magandang araw sa inyong lahat, most especially to all the Filipinos in different parts of the world. Lovely to meet you all.
We have to be on our best behavior. Nasanay ko sa no, but before we dig into your respective professions, describe niyo naman sa amin kung saan kayo nag-work ngayon. Aside from let's start with Ms. Rachel before I move in.
Yeah, I'm a secondary English teacher here in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia in Riyadh. So, tinuturuan ko po yung mga anak, most especially ng ating OFWs here in Riyadh, children of engineers, teachers as well, doctors and nurses. So this is a full Filipino school. So lahat ng nandito ay Filipino lang. Yes po. We actually built an entire Filipino community here in Saudi Arabia.
Yes, I love that. Like everybody together. And at least you know, yeah. You guys can study Philippine history, right? And speak Tagalog freely para hindi mawala yung kultura natin kahit nasa ibang bansa kayo. I love that. That's awesome.
Yes.
And everybody can relax together, diba? But what about you? What have you been doing aside from the YouTube channel?
Misty, I have been teaching in the Department of Education for 6 years now. I have also taught English subjects in college for 2 years. And that's it. I relished the idea of teaching as a senior high school teacher in Ikawayan, Bulacan.
Wow.
Proud Bulacanya here.
Gusto ko yung this is it, pero ang dami niyang sinabi. Parang hindi yun it. Ang laki ng responsibility.
I'm sorry. It should be the end of the statement. Oh.
No, I mean, like, that's a lot. You guys are doing and molding so many different minds. It's a huge responsibility that a lot of people take for granted. You guys are making such a huge mark.
Thank you for the appreciating.
Future. Yes, and world peace. Carmela, take it away.
Okay, so first question. Like, tell us, how did you begin this passion? How did this passion grow for teaching?
When I was a kid, like in the Philippines, in our province, I lived near Banco Central. So I've always dreamt of working there. Also in high school, I would entertain notions of other careers like, nursing or in any medical field. Also, technically, hindi ko naman talaga priority ang teaching. It just so happened that it was the priority course of my scholarship. So wala yung accountancy. Kung hindi ko pupunin ang education, they'll withdraw the scholarship from me. As what I always say to my students, even my friends, my family, I knew that I was on the right puzzle. Kasi yung akala kong bagay that will take me years to embrace and digest, ay first love ko pala. I remember asking my elementary school teachers for extra handouts so I could practice school on my own time.
Well, for me, it's a different story because ever since I was a child, I have always been dreaming of becoming a teacher. I remember when I was in the third grade that I would get some chalk from my teacher and then bring it back home and then garner all of the younger children in our neighborhood and then teach them everything that I know, everything that I learned from that specific day. And then there comes the high school, the college. I remember I'm not really focused on the subject that my teachers teach, but on their process of teaching. So simula pa lang, talagang pinipick up ko na yung mga best practices nila kasi gusto ko talagang magturo, mag-share.
Yan pala yung side effect ng shock. Pag nalanghap mo, shock lang.
Iba yung epekto.
Iba pala kasi shock talaga yung may salarin. No, I'm kidding. I love that. I love that you guys would share. It always comes down to the process that leads to sharing.
Yeah, and this is it, because the thing is with all these new sources of information that are out right now, how has that changed your passion, if at all?
The passion for teaching, of course, we know that our culture here is the students should go to school and then should come home with new learning, new knowledge. So with the digital age, every information is readily available. In just one click, you can have all of the answers that you want. So I adjusted. I created a YouTube channel so that whenever my students are having hard time understanding the concept, the complex concepts of grammar, they can just search me on YouTube. Then they can watch that together with their family while enjoying family time. They could also learn.
Without pressure of, sometimes in class, nakaka-intimidate din kasi talaga.
Yes, I have also read some comments in my YouTube that, Ma'am, thank you po kasi hindi po kayo na-memressure. Thank you po, Ma'am, kasi I feel relaxed watching you. Para nanonood lang po ng pelikula pero natututo. Hindi po katulad ng teacher
namin. Pwede mag-pause.
Na terror. Yeah. Exactly. And then they can just digest the information that you just shared.
So I've been teaching for almost 5 years now. And I was able to experience the most challenging stages of education, teaching and learning process. Because it was a transition from face-to-face online, and then the hybrid setup in which I have students online and I have students in a face-to-face setup. So I needed to prepare twice as much as I did before the pandemic. So I had to prepare digital resources, learning resources, at the same time the physical resources that I can give to my students in the face-to-face setup. So it was really quite challenging, but I still do believe that teaching is a commitment. It's an endless planning, so you will need to give your full life to it, at least, or if not full, half of it. So you need to be scholarly, you have to be involved, you need to know how to decide when given critical choices. You know, you have to instill discipline in kids who aren't yours or who aren't even in front of you. So it's quite challenging, but yeah. We're all here, so I still do believe that I was an effective and will still be an effective teacher, despite of all the availability of the knowledge. Yes.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you. Sorry. No, but I was going to say that on behalf of all parents, thank you. Thank you both so much.
You're most welcome.
I was just imagining myself, like every time I watch my son, because he does hybrid, every time I'm watching him, you know, in class, and I see how the teachers have to balance, you know, the students being present and then online, I'm just like, oh my God. And then they're so noisy and magulupa. I try to imagine myself as the head of the class, like as a teacher, and I'm just like, girl, ang dami ko sigurong white hair. This teaching is truly amazing. It makes a lasting impact on people for their whole lives, basically. You know, you open them up to so many different things in this world, but we will talk to them more about their respective journeys as educators. Let's continue our inspiring Chikahan when we return here on BRGY.
Hi guys, I'm Jake Wenka, and I'm here to tell you kung anong hindi nawawala sa akin pag nagtitaping ako ng The Iron Heart. And for me, I think one thing that I always have no matter what as Eros is a watch. I have specific watches na sinusuot ko for Eros, and it also helps me. It helps me na when I get to the set, syempre we tape in Cebu, and I see the watch, it helps me get into character as well. So yeah, that's one thing na certainly pag Eros na ako, I always have to be wearing a watch, and specific to Eros.